Hi, I'm Allie Beyer, and I'll be your instructor this semester for the history of television. I teach this class both in an online version as well as an in-person version on campus in Chicago. I love television, and I love teaching this class. My favorite show that's currently on regular broadcast TV is probably The Flash. I'm a superhero fan, and I collected comic books as a kid, and I still kind of do. And I really, really enjoy watching these superhero narratives continue in both cinema as well as in television. It's really fun for me to watch the heroes of my youth be visualized in this medium. It's very exciting. Other shows that I watch right now and I'm really excited about, a lot of them are on Netflix, especially The Get Down. And the online version of this class, does require a Netflix streaming account, and so you can take advantage of a lot of the Netflix original series that are currently on. And The Get Down, Orange is the New Black, House of Cards are some of the shows that I really enjoy from that internet form of television. And television is really an exciting medium to be a part of right now because it is changing because of the internet. We'll be looking at the early years of television, which starts in 1939 with the New York City World's Fair, which is considered the public debut in this country, and then we'll continue all the way up into the internet age. It's really fun if you're a creator, a producer, or a writer of television to look at some of what's worked in the history of television and what hasn't. And some of the things that have worked in the past might work today, and other things will kind of time out and they will have only fit into a certain era. It's really exciting to study that as makers of this medium. A little bit about myself. I currently live in Madison, Wisconsin, which is my hometown. So when I commute down to campus on Wednesdays, I'm only on campus once a week. I'm very available before or after class, but I'm not available at all on other days of the week. You can also get a hold of me whether you're in the in-person version of this class or the online version by writing me emails. I'll get back to you promptly. If I don't get back to you within 24 hours, it's irregular and I would ask that you write me again. There's probably a technological situation or a miscommunication and I've missed the email altogether. So in general, I will get back to you in 24 hours. If you'd like to meet with me virtually, if you're not available to meet on campus before or after class, or you just want to keep everything online if you're in the virtual classroom, I'm also available to meet with you via chats, or we could set up a Skype or other kind of conference call, or just the kind of old-fashioned telephone if you prefer. Do ask me questions if you have any. And again, email is the best way to get a hold of me. In addition to teaching this class, my little cat Moose just came over. That's what I'm looking down at, so you can say hi to her. Moose, say hi really quick. This is my kitty cat, and me and Moose live in Madison, Wisconsin. And I am an artist myself. I don't make moving images for a television distribution. I make things more for a fine art or gallery output, but I do work with the moving image, and I am excited by technology and some of the production techniques that you guys utilize in the television department are things that I work on in my own artistic projects. I'm also an art handler or an artist assistant. I've worked in museums and galleries helping a lot of other artists accomplish their dreams and make their technological situations come to life. And for me, that's also a very, very fun way to employ some of my own skill set. So I'll be talking a lot about the history of television. I'll also be talking about some of the technological aspects of the medium, as well as continually how television is a reflection of American society. What we see on our small screens is often some of the most real things that we see historically when we look at America. So since television debuts in this country, we have kind of a mirror of what society looks like, and we'll be looking at that, and we'll be analyzing not only what we do see on our TV screens, but what we don't, and why images on our screens that we see in the 1950s are very different than some of the images that we might see today. So I'm looking forward to getting to know all of you and talking about television and getting to know you each, whether in person or in the virtual classroom. I hope that you all are as excited by this medium as I am, and I'm sure that I'll discover new shows from all of you, as well as showing you some of my historical favorites. Thanks a lot.